Today we're going to talk about how to configure the Ivanti Environment Manager integration that is in Ivanti Endpoint Manager version 2018.1. Environment Manager lets you personalize user desktops and use policy controls to protect endpoints. This integration allows you to edit and save Environment Manager policies to Endpoint Manager. You can then use Endpoint Manager to deploy those policies. Let's get started with the configuration process. First, I need to deploy the Environment Manager agent to the devices I manage. I can do this by opening up the Ivanti Management Console and clicking on Configuration from the toolbox. Under Configuration, I click the Agent Configuration menu option to look at the agent configurations that are available. From this list, I'll double-click the agent configuration that I use, in this case, a Windows default configuration. That brings me to the agent configuration window. And I can see that here, I'm already on the start page, so I just need to make sure that the Environment Manager policy is selected. I'll save that and deploy the agent configuration to manage devices. My next step is to deploy the Environment Manager license file. Ivanti sends this to you when you purchase Environment Manager. If I go to my core server and follow the path from Program Files to LandDesk into the Management Suite and the LandDesk files, this is the place where I'll want to have my license file. Once the license file is in place, I can go back to the Management Console. From the Distribution option in the toolbox, I can go to Distribution Packages. I double-click on Environment Manager License Deployment in the Public Packages list to view the Environment Manager License Deployment properties. From there, a new window pops up, and if I go to the Additional Files section, I can see that I can choose files that are required for installation. I'll make sure that I'm looking at my Core Server LandDesk files here, and then I'll find the license file in the Available Files list. I click on it, move it to the Additional Files menu by clicking on the arrow, and that will make it so that I'm ready to deploy the Environment Manager License Deployment package. I make sure I save the page before exiting, and then I can schedule tasks and move ahead with deployment. When the Environment Manager agent and license file have been deployed to the devices I manage, I'm ready to connect the Endpoint Manager core server to the Environment Manager console. To do this, I'm going to need to find the core server secret key. In my core server file explorer, I'll follow the file path through my program data folder by showing hidden file locations. From here, I'll go to the LandDesk Service Desk section and click on the folder called My Identity Server. Here I've found the JSON file with my key in it, so I'll open it with Notepad to see what's inside. I'll search for EM client secret so I can find what I need more quickly. The key I need is this string by value before the EM client secret description. I'll leave that open so that I can grab it in a moment. Now that I've got the secret key, I'll go ahead and go back to the Management Console and find the Environment Manager Policy button under Configuration in the toolbar. This brings up the Environment Manager console. Within Environment Manager, I click File, Save As, and select Configuration from Endpoint Manager. A new window pops up where I'll need to tell Environment Manager which server is being connected. If I click the New Server button, another window appears asking for information about the server I want to add. This is where I'll enter my core server name, and I'll also go ahead and give it a friendly name. The prompt that says Secret is where I'll want to use that key I found earlier. The last item I need is the location. And if I don't have the M folder I want, I can create that by browsing. After that, I just need to click Add and Connect, and provide credentials if necessary. Now any configurations I've created will be in the configurations list. Now I have Environment Manager configured with the agents and license files deployed to the proper devices and the Endpoint Manager core server connected to the Environment Manager console. I'm ready to use Endpoint Manager to deploy new or modified policies that will affect the devices I manage.